Hello children and welcome back to our class. Hope you must be good. Before we move ahead with our second video, let's recapitulate all that we learnt in our previous video. Children, we learnt about the poet laureate Alfred Lord Tennyson. We dealt with the title and introduction of the poem. We also learnt the thematic structure, tone, mood, language, and also the message of the poem. Children, in today's video, we would be inspecting the poem. So now, open your book, Oxford Inc. English Reader, Section 3, page number 29, The Charge of the Light Brigade by Alfred Lord Tennyson. Let us first read the introduction, which is given below the title. On 25th October 1854, during the Battle of Balaclava in the Crimean War, owing to the miscommunication of an order from a British officer, 600 cavalry soldiers of the British Light Brigade rode out to attack a battery of Russian artillery that was fully armed and well prepared to face the assault. The Light Brigade was met by a hail of deadly enemy fire, which killed most of the cavalry men in the brigade. Children, let's discuss. Were these men heroes or just unfortunate victims of a ghastly error? Would you carry out an order given to you by someone in authority? Authority means power. Even if you believed that it to be wrong or foolish. Kindly look for the answers of these questions, and when we'll meet, we'll definitely discuss it. The poem, The Charge of the Light Brigade, has been divided into six stanzas, out of which we would be dealing with three stanzas today. Read a poem now that was written just 6 weeks after the event described above, that celebrates the courage of the soldiers who carried out their orders in spite of knowing that they were doomed to die. Let's read the first stanza of the poem. Page number 29. Half a league, half a league, half a league onward, all in the valley of death rode the 600. Forward the Light Brigade, charge for the guns, he said, into the valley of death rode the 600. Children, league refers to a distance of about 3 miles. Now let's see the explanation of the first stanza. The poem begins with the phrase half a league, which is repeated 3 times, which is to create a poetic effect as well as to symbolize the parade of the Light Brigade towards the enemy during the Crimean War. League is an old method of measuring distance and is equal to around 3 miles. Hence, half a league would mean 1.5, that is 1.5 miles. The soldiers were commanded to march towards the enemy country, which was probably 1.5 miles ahead. They were 600 in number, and according to the poet, they were marching in the valley of death. Their death was for sure. The poet uses the phrase valley of death to show that they, that is the Light Brigade, were soon going to be killed. Valley of Death is a line from the Bible, Psalm 23, which is often read at funerals, which reminds us of death. It shows that the brave soldiers moved ahead gallantly to die for the sake of their country and God. It is an honorable and noble way to die. Children, Light Brigade refers to a formation of soldiers on horseback, cavalry, who are not very heavily armed. Valley of Death is a line from the Bible, Psalm 23, which is often read at funerals, which reminds us of death. It shows that the soldiers moved ahead gallantly to die for the sake of their country and God. It is an honorable and noble way to die. The commander, who is referred to as he here, commands the soldiers to move towards the enemies and charge
that is attack the enemies, to either or to destroy those holding the guns. These lines highlights the blind obedience the soldiers follow in war. In reality, it was a command that was misunderstood. Children, now let's read the second stanza. Forward the Light Brigade. Was there a man dismayed? Not though the soldier knew someone had blundered. There's not to make reply. There's not to reason why. There's but to do and die into the valley of death. The second stanza highlights the men's courage as they obey the command to ride forward. The second stanza begins with the command of their leader, Forward the Light Brigade. The poet wonders whether any of the soldiers of the brigade frightened because of the fatal danger ahead, and answers himself that they didn't know which the fear is, though the idea of marching towards the enemy was a blunder committed by someone. Command is repeated to show the sense of urgency. Order is given, but the commander is unknown. Here the poet questions, was there a man dismayed? Were the soldiers afraid? Even the soldiers were unaware that the command to charge forward was a mistake committed by someone. Someone had blundered. Someone had made a mistake by passing such an order, which will lead everyone to death. The cavalry were unaware of the mistake, and being loyal and strong, they did not question the order. Their duty is to follow the command blindly, even though they have to die doing it. The repetition of the phrase Valley of Death emphasizes the main action of the poem, which is the 600 soldiers riding towards their death. The brave soldiers neither request their leader to return back or question his command. They have nothing else in mind but to fight and die for their country, and hence they marched into the valley of death. Children, now let's read the final stanza for the day of the poem. Cannon to right of them, cannon to left of them, cannon in front of them, volleyed and thundered, stormed at with shot and shell, boldly they rode and well, into the jaws of death, into the mouth of hell, rode the 600. Children, now let's see the explanation of this stanza. This stanza provides a vivid description of what the soldiers face as they ride into the valley. The poet here refers to the soldiers being surrounded by gunfire on three sides, left, right, and in front of them. They are trapped by enemy from all sides. Cannon to right of them, cannon to left of them, cannon in front of them. This is an alliteration which adds to the brutality bombarded by the cannons. The soldiers were violently attacked with bullets and explosives. However, they rode on bravely as commanded. This stanza describes the atmosphere of a battlefield. The bullets and the shells of the guns and cannons, respectively, were flowing in the air, but the soldiers didn't stop and moved ahead into the jaws of death, into the mouth of hell. The valley is personified as a trap, the jaws of a deadly monster from which no one can escape. The mouth of hell refers to a metaphor. The valley is chaotic and is compared to hell. The lines above creates the picture of the troops of soldiers being eaten up by a monster and going into a fairy hell that means death. Children, hope you must have understood the explanation of the first three stanzas. I'll meet you again tomorrow with the remaining part of the poem, that is the last three stanzas. Till then, take care.